Good morning, Wisconsin. Morning, world. It's a new day. Thanks for kicking it off with us right here at WFHR. Got your host, James, here. I am joined by our head of news, our co-host in studio, Melissa Kaye.
Good morning.
Good to have you here, Mel.
Yeah. It's a little weird. I don't have a mute button.
Yeah, it is a little weird. It is a little weird.
I need a mute button.
You just give me the, hey, I'll hit you. I'll mute you. We got good stuff lined up for you this morning, and we kick things off the best way we can with our good friend, Brittney Merlot, talking a little Mother Nature. Good morning, Britt.
Good morning. How are you guys?
Great. Mm-hmm. How are you? Mm-hmm.
Good. Feeling like fall. It's a good morning. I didn't really want to get out of bed. You know, the cloud cover and the windy conditions. I'm like, I'll just stay here.
So true.
But it's not actually that cold out. I wore a light jacket and I was just fine.
Yes, which is how fall should feel, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Perfect.
Yes, 100%. Mm-hmm. Yes. Could you work on that for us?
Yeah.
I'm trying my best.
Thank you,
Brittany. I mean, today, right where you're feeling right now, we're only going to get 6 degrees warmer. So we're just going to be pretty much hovering with what you're feeling at this moment. In those mid-50s, winds are going to still be feisty. They're gusting up to 35 miles per hour. And earlier this morning, I was seeing that they're sustained a constant wind at about 20 through Wisconsin Rapids. So pretty breezy. That'll stay the case throughout the entire day. More and more sunshine by the afternoon and into the evening, which also means with the clear skies, we're going to see some below freezing temperatures tonight. So we will fall to about 30 degrees overnight before we spike warmer for tomorrow. It's a roller coaster.
It really is.
Welcome
really
to Wisconsin.
Is. Yes. Yeah. Wait 5 minutes and bring a change of clothes. Bring yeah. a couple, every season worth of clothes.
But you know what I heard in that forecast was the sustained winds. Brittany, can you direct them to blow all the leaves off my yard into the street? Because that's where they're supposed to be.
Yeah. I can do that.
Awesome.
Thank you.
You're the best.
Good. She is good.
We got the line to the weather goddess here.
No hesitation. Just yes, yes, done. Like, we appreciate you, Brittany.
I'll just whip up that Leaf NATO. It'll be fine.
Yeah.
Leaf NATO. Yes, Leaf NATO.
I love it.
Which is also another thing. One more thing to throw into our you know, forecast lexicon now is a leaf tornado. There we go. Appreciate you, Brett. Have a good morning.
You too.
Good to have her back with us. I appreciate
it. Oh,
yeah. Thanks so much, Brittany, for joining us. You joined us every hour in every morning in this time slot right here. We get to start off our day talking to Brittany, and we're able to do that with our phones working.
Yeah.
A big shout out to Solaris and to our engineer team working real hard on that one. As somebody who is going to be doing a sports show later this afternoon, I'm very happy about that.
Yeah.
It's a call-in show.
It is a call-in show.
My voice is still beat from Monday, so we're looking forward to that. That's great. A big shout out to all of them working hard on that.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a reminder, our phone lines are wide open, 715-424-2600. Anything Melissa and I are getting into today that you want to jump in on, we encourage you to do so, everybody.
Absolutely. And it's just one button dial in with the Civic Media app. Or you can call 715-424-2600.
We're looking forward to getting into some of the more popular Halloween candies to hand out this year. You want to be the top one on your block. We're going to have the right candy for you.
You know what, James? This is important information because it got me 10 cents off my coffee in Minnesota when I was there over the weekend.
Wow.
Because I guessed their favorite candy for the state.
Very cool. Very cool.
See, this is important information, people.
You never know where this information is going to help you out. You might be on Jeopardy, and a question pops up, and boom, there you
What's
go.
What's Wisconsin's
gotcha.
Favorite Halloween candy?
We got you. See? We'll get into a little bit of Halloween safety tips as well. We've got the first climate smart food in the U.S. that is shipping, and it's shipping right here from Wisconsin.
Cool.
Get into that a little bit. And we got some other fun things we'll be getting into. A Chinese exhibit has dogs disguised as pandas. I don't know if there's really any educational value in that story, but I want to cover it.
Dogs are cheaper than pandas?
Yeah. It is a Wednesday. That means we'll be joined by our friends from Quality Plus Printing, getting your words out right here in Wisconsin Rapids.
Wicked awesome.
Looking forward to that. 9 o'clock hour is going to have some entertainment news in there for you. We're looking forward to talking about some local theater. I got some great things going on there. and useless things you have memorized that you still remember years later, but they don't really help you at all. We'll get into that topic. Start thinking of what your answer might be, everybody out there, because we want to hear from you about that. And if we got time today, I got another one of those great articles of 10 offbeat towns in Wisconsin.
Okay.
We'll go ahead and discover those. Travel the state a little bit here with some of that.
Which is just awesome. We have a beautiful state.
Really do. And any chance we get to kind of highlight that, mm-hmm. we like to do so. Got other information, of course. We'll be getting into our schedule here today and a couple of other fun things. Looking forward to getting into all of that. But first, we start off with, especially this time of year, something we like to cover quite a bit, giant pumpkins.
Yes.
And we go to Fond du Lac for this one. just in time for Halloween, Wisconsin's heaviest ever giant pumpkin was recently crowned at a fall festival.
Whoa.
The 2,551-pound Atlantic giant took first prize at the 2024 River Prairie Ginormous Pumpkin Festival way off in Altoona. The prize-winning plant was grown by veteran giant pumpkin grower Jim Ford, who grew it in his garden in El Dorado, a town in Fond du Lac.
Nice.
Nicely done, sir. Showing Melissa a little bit of the pictures from this gigantic, beautiful...
Whoa, that is a big pumpkin.
There it is.
Yeah.
That thing is...
They're not messing around.
I like that they put a hat on it. They put a giant hat. Yes. I don't know where they found that hat. Oh, that is a giant...
Somebody made that. Crafted with love.
Had to be.
For a ginormous pumpkin.
Every year, it feels like this record is getting broken with the giant pumpkins. And I always get a kick out of these. I love them. A shout out to, of course, Nakusa and the Great Pumpkin Fest.
Yes, getting to see the giant pumpkin drop from that. That is a really cool experience.
It's awesome. If you haven't done it, you have to do it, everybody. It's something that you've got to put on your list.
Next year is going to be real special.
Yeah. That's what I'm hearing. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a fun one. So with these things, Melissa, my question for you, for the audience is, one... What would you do with this if this was yours? And one as a side note, we can all say, okay, we'd put some of it to our food shelters out there. I always appreciate when people ever break these records for biggest sub sandwich, and they they cut it up, and some people eat some, but they usually give it to food shelters and things. Mm-hmm. Let's put that to the side that we would definitely do that. What else you would do with the pumpkin? I'm very curious, and I'm curious of what would you like grow a giant of if you could, a giant tomato. Giant celery stick.
Well, first off, I would live in it.
Oh, yes!
And second, if I could grow a giant anything, this is from my childhood fantasies, it would be a giant maraschino cherry, which I would also live in. It might be my summer home. And the pumpkin is my winter home.
Yes, yeah, it makes sense.
And
it's only
I can
logical.
Just, eat the walls. It's the best of all worlds.
I'm so glad I asked this question. I'm actually really happy right now that my everything I had planned for today went out the window, because this is a much better topic than what I had planned. It's a fantastic answer. Of course you would live in
of
it. Why
course.
Wouldn't you live in
Have
it?
Have you not seen James and the Giant Peach?
Yeah, I mean, come on. That story was my sister, I think it was her favorite story growing up, and I swear she only liked it because it would annoy me. It would bug me.
Because the main character is James.
Yes. And her, my brother, I don't know why they thought this was funny, but they'd walk around and like randomly like, where's your peach, James? Where's your peach?
That is such a sibling thing to do.
And they thought it was the most funny thing in the world.
And the funny part was that it annoyed you.
Yes. Yeah. But it was half the time they wouldn't even be able to say the sentence before they'd keep laughing. And they wouldn't. And I just knew what they were going to say. I think it'd be really cool to grow a giant apple. I think that would be cool. I'd like to do something like that. The pumpkin, I'm turning that into pumpkin pie. I'm turning all of it into pumpkin pie. And I'm going from this, the most giant pumpkin, to the biggest pumpkin pie.
Mm.
I want to make that with this. It
with
just seems
that.
To make
it
sense. Just,
it goes hand in hand. We won't talk about the fact when, vegetables or fruits get that big, they have a tendency to not taste good or be good for food. But we can let that aside since we're total fantasy world here.
I'm
living in it. You're turning it into a giant pie.
I love this. I love it. But I also, is that true?
I believe
true,
so. I believe so.
I haven't heard that before. Wow, that's interesting.
Well, it's because they're grown to just be so big. They're not grown to taste good.
It's one of those things when you hear it, it's like, oh, that makes sense. But I never even thought of that before.
But I don't know if that's true about pumpkins, and I could be misinformed. Mm. So, I'm not a expert in giant pumpkins. We should call Heather. We should call Heather Sayers. She is the president of the Nacusa Giant Pumpkin Festival. She would know.
I would love to get, like, I love talking to specialists in any field. I don't care what their specialty is. I love diving, going on a deep dive with people on things like that. And I would love to talk to a grower. I'd love to talk to one of our people in our ag industry that does this, that actually makes a, I don't know, it's a hobby. I don't think anybody makes it as a profession.
Well, they're not going to grow a whole field of giant pumpkins.
That'd be awesome, though. Oh my God, that'd be awesome. I can't imagine what you would turn this into as a jack-o'-lantern. I'm trying, like, something like you'd almost like a picture. You'd almost want like the Mona Lisa or something.
Well, they actually had a couple of those at the Nacusa Giant Pumpkin Fest where they carved they were pretty big. I mean, they were like Santa's belly size big.
Yeah, really.
And they carved a scene into the front of the pumpkin, like not all the way through where you could put a lantern in there, but into the flesh of the pumpkin. It was really cool. It was like a relief.
That's interesting.
That's nice. The word.
Yes.
Relief.
One of the things that was interesting in this article that I came across about this great thing that Mr. Ford did, you can find it at the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, MilwaukeeJournalSentinel.com. Go ahead and check that out if you can get past the paywalls on some of those. Ford has been growing giant pumpkins for nearly 25 years, and he said the knowledge he's acquired over the decades is the most important part of raising a record-setting pumpkin. Quote, we learn every year. Just like life, I already know what I'm going to do different next year. Even though he broke the record with this one, he can see some things that he did wrong. Yeah. And it's really important to him to respect the land and to respect these plants, these things that he grows and everything. Mm-hmm. Making sure that they live well, that they're growing well and everything, which is kind of cool. I don't hear that very often with some of these. As far as, you know, respect, just the dedication to the land and everything. Yeah. I admire that.
No, that's awesome.
Ford has grown quite a few of these before, but of course, none this big. A shout out to him and a congratulations. Taking a quick look at our fall report, our autumn report, if you will. The Autumn Digest that I like to go.
There you go.
All of Wisconsin is changing, everybody. It is there. There's pretty much no spot that isn't in at least 35 to 40% by now. And it really kind of happened overnight. Over the weekend, I mean, I should say. Mm-hmm. Juneau County is at peak. So is Portage. I would say that Marathon is also in peak coverage. Greene County is in peak coverage. So everybody at 75 to 80%. Mm-hmm. And of course, locally here in Wood County, we are at a strong, and I mean strong, 70%. No, that's not right. Where is that? Huh. We're at 70% last I looked. Marshfield's at 95, Stevens Point's at peak color at 90, and Plover is at 80.
And with these sustained strong winds we're going to get, that's going to blow a lot of leaves off the trees.
Yeah. Toma's at 90. That's what I was looking for. Toma's at 90, Adams County at 90, Dell's at 90. So, this is the time, everybody. This is the time. Get on out there.
See them now before they're gone.
Yeah.
When I was driving back from Duluth this weekend, there were a lot of leaves gone up there, but there were still a lot of pretty colors.
It already seems like it's as quickly as it came. It's just gone already. You know?
Yeah, that's how it goes.
It's too fast.
Enjoy the seasons. They are fleeting.
It's too fast. I want it slower. We will take a quick commercial break. We will come back and do some celebrating with our great friends over at El Cafe and the Birthday and Anniversary Club. It's Melissa and James taking you through your morning right here at WFHR. Happy birthday. Haven't heard this one in a while.
I hear it every time.
Do you?
If only in my head.
It just sticks with you. We're going to be updating these, I think. It's just hard to find birthday songs.
It is.
There's not a lot of them. There's not a ton of them. It's time to do some celebrating with our good friends over at El Cafe and the Birthday and Anniversary Club.
Time to get stuffed.
We appreciate our friends over at El Cafe. Go visit them today, everybody, at 221 Market Avenue in beautiful Port Edwards. Get stuffed with our friends at El Cafe.
El Cafe.
They got some great specials going on over there. And
that's what we're referring to. Just to be clear.
Yes.
Because it is all stuffed all week.
Go check it out, everybody. Different specials every day. Great specials every day for you. And some of the most unique items you're going to find, along with your traditional favorites and everything. They know their audience. They listen to their community. They are taking good care of that community and putting into that community. Support those that support us. Buy local, support local. Support our friends at El Cafe today, 221 Market Avenue in beautiful Port Edwards. Mm-hmm. Get us those birthdays and anniversaries. Love celebrating with you, everybody. Get them to info@WFHR.com. You can, of course, direct message us on our Facebook pages as well. And now you can even call up.
That's right. Our phones are working. Call 715-424-2600. I almost forgot the number. It's been too long since I said it. Or better yet, call us with the Civic Media app. It's just one button dial-in. You don't have to remember a number. Don't have to remember a number, but you do have to remember how to talk, Melissa. And the app is free. And then you can take us everywhere, in your pocket, all the time, because you know that's what you want.
You know you want to. Go ahead and download it, and thank you to everybody who already has. And keep that topic in mind, Melissa, a little bit later when we get into useless things you memorized that you remember years later. We will get into that later. But for now, we got some great birthdays to celebrate. Melissa, I need a 1 through 3.
Let's go with 2.
And that gives us the qualifier, so we can get right into the celebrating. First up, we want to wish a happy birthday to Tracy Steinbeck.
Happy birthday, Tracy.
Enjoy your day, Trace. Hope it's a good one for you. Have a great day, and thank you so much for getting us this birthday.
Yes.
And thank you for also getting us the anniversary of the 22nd anniversary of Steve and Jennifer Spaeth.
Oh, Steve and Jennifer, 22nd?
That's
wow.
Cool.
Yeah. Happy anniversary.
Enjoy that day, everybody. I hope it's a good one for you, Steve and Jennifer. Enjoy that day. Mm-hmm. And our qualifier, celebrating our birthday, Oli Olson.
Oli, happy birthday.
That's a beautiful name.
It is.
O-L-E, Oli Olson.
Oli.
That's great. God, that's a good name. I love that name so much. That's great. happy birthday, Oli.
Happy birthday.
Enjoy your birthday. Hope it's a great one for you.
Mm-hmm.
And thanks again to everybody that got us these birthdays and anniversaries. We love celebrating with you guys.
Always want more.
Taking a look at our celebrity list, one of the better directors in the game, Ang Lee, is 70 today. Director of so many great action movies, and along with like Brokeback Mountain and a couple of other ones like that, where when he goes away from action, he goes really like heavy into drama and some of that. But a very talented, very good director.
All right.
Very talented, very good musician, singer, songwriter, wonderful steel guitar player. Dwight Yoakam is 68 today.
Ooh, 68. Wow.
I didn't mention also great actor, director. Dwight Yoakam, way better than average director. Or actor, I should say. I'm going to lose some people on this one, I think. But the movie Sling Blade, that is probably maybe his most famous role. I feel like he out-acts Billy Bob Thornton in it.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Really. I was. I didn't even know who. I didn't know much about Dwight Yoakam other than he was a great steel guitar player.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't listen to a lot of country growing up or anything, especially when he was at his peak. But I knew good guitar playing when I heard it. I'm like, okay, well, and a name like Dwight Yoakam, you're going to recognize.
Right.
You're going to remember a name like that. I didn't know that he was getting into acting when I watched Sling Blade. I had no idea what he looked like, anything like that.
Who he was, yeah.
Blew me away. He was so good in that movie. Good actor. And again, if anything else, that steel guitar playing of Dwight Yoakam's is worth the listen alone. Let's see here. Weird Al Yankovic is 65 today.
Yes, Weird Al.
That's awesome. Woo. Awesome. You're going to have one of the better selling music careers. You're going to have a career that's going to stretch 3 to 4 decades. And towards the end of your career, at 68, or in your late 60s,
yeah,
65.
He's only 65, yep.
You are going to still be relevant.
Yeah.
You are still relevant. You are still known. And you're going to do all this being a parody artist.
Yeah.
And I guess not even necessarily just a parody artist, like the greatest ever to do it. Like nobody will ever.
Well, that's how you keep this going, by being the greatest, which is what he did.
And among all those things, I think maybe the thing that might stand out more than anything else about Weird Al Yankovic's career, other than the great movie UHF, it's a rough movie. It's a rough movie. The respect he has in the music industry.
Mm-hmm.
Like there, if I got this right, I'm almost 100% on this. There's no parody he's made where he didn't reach out to the artist and the artist didn't okay it. And oftentimes he over a course of his career would have artists reach out to him.
Say, please do the song.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Like, you wouldn't expect that, and especially how serious musicians can tend to take themselves and everything. Mm-hmm. It's pretty impressive. Pretty cool.
No, that is awesome.
It speaks highly to his character too. Mm-hmm. He's always been very approachable, easy to work with. A lot of that.
I would guess self-deprecating.
Yes. Yes. Very much. Very much so. The great director Sam Raimi is 65 today. Fantastic director. It Ends With Us and so many other movies that he has done. Really good actor. Really good director. Really good actor. I'm saying that because I'm looking at Ryan Reynolds. Ryan Reynolds is 48 today. Obviously, just a huge hit with Deadpool and Wolverine, still making money in the box office. It's the biggest R-rated movie of all time, biggest superhero movie of all time, and it's still collecting money. Among all those things, though, Ryan Reynolds did something that you don't see very often in the game, and it worked nonetheless. He bet on himself. He put so much money and so much time into this Deadpool movie, and his reputation and a lot of his future jobs that he was offered that he wasn't able to do because of what he was putting into this movie and everything. And three movies later, again, biggest movie in the world right now, and one of the biggest of all time. Not to mention guy who goes out of his way. He's got like 18 different businesses out there, but almost every one of them have a cause that they are for, and that the majority of those proceeds are going into.
That's awesome.
Including the Mint Mobile thing that he just sold, and wanted to have people have cheap phones. Wanted people to have cheaper phone lines and thought that it cost too much. Mm-hmm. And just kind of took the ball and ran with it. This is a guy that if he wants to do something, he finds a way to make it happen.
Yeah, he just does it.
Yeah, really
and
good.
And now the world is his oyster. That man could do whatever he wants.
Pretty much,
because,
yeah.
I mean, not only is he proven that he is a sure thing, he is pretty much gorgeous.
Oh yeah. This is another tough one to say, but I believe that Ryan Reynolds may be, if not now, he will go down as the greatest ever to break the fourth wall. I don't think anybody's ever been better at breaking the fourth wall and just like tongue in cheek winking to the audience
in a
or
movie.
Anything.
Yes,
in a movie.
Yes.
Yeah.
It happens more often in theater, but that's such a limited audience.
Yeah.
Whereas a movie like this that is worldwide.
It's one of my favorite things when it's done right, and he is so good at it. He has been through his whole career, even going back to like Van Wilder and some of those movies and everything that he did. He's good. Emily Clark is 38. Most people know her, of course, from Game of Thrones. But she's been making the rounds. She's been in a lot of things lately. She's jumped into the Marvel Universe and done some things there. Very good actor. Very good actor. And let's see here. Director Phil Kaufman, the Right Stuff director, 88 today for him. Diana Reeves, great jazz singer. She is 68 today. And, of course, we want to wish happy birthdays and anniversaries to everybody else out there celebrating that maybe didn't get to us with their birthday or anniversary.
For sure. It's still not too late. You can call up 715-424-2600. Sneak it in at the last minute.
You got the whole show. You got the whole show. You can call up anytime and join us.
Oh, man. You're giving them the whole show, James?
Yes.
Jeepers.
Yes, yes.
Why are you making this so easy?
Melissa, I don't have anything to talk about today. We need them to fill. No. We got plenty to talk about.
I never believe you say that. believe you.
We've got some good stuff on the way for you, everybody. We're going to talk about what is the best Halloween candy to hand out this year, wherever you're listening.
Please tell me, because I need to go buy some.
We got that coming up. We got some Halloween safety tips we will get into. And a little bit later, we're going to have our Quality Plus Printing Wicked Awesome Word of Wednesday.
Wicked Awesome.
It's coming up right here on The Morning Show at WFHR, locally grown radio. Welcome back, everybody. Morning Show at WFHR. Melissa and James hanging out with you. We hope you're having a fantastic Wednesday out there, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Can't get enough of that song. Good things coming up for you. We'll be joined by Phil Hartley in our Quality Plus Printing Wicked Awesome Word of Wednesday. Looking forward to that coming up in a little bit. But I've been waiting to get into this one with you, Melissa. The first climate smart food in the U.S. is now shipping, and it is coming right from your homeland of Wisconsin, everybody.
Woo-hoo.
This long grain white rice and brown rice from a Great River Milling in Fountain City are the first consumer products created under the U.S. Department of Agriculture's Partnership for Climate Smart Commodities program.
Nice.
I don't know what the acronym for that is. I don't. The $3 billion grant program was launched back in 2022 to support farmers and ag business finding ways to invest in more sustainable agricultural practices.
Nice. The program, important.
Yeah.
I don't know. Do you want to eat?
It feels like a good call.
Yeah.
Feels like, even though it's something I forget to do almost every day, it does feel like a good idea to remember to eat and to have good food, and just to have food in general,
just
pretty
to
much.
Be able to have food. Yes.
The $3 billion grant. Is being put to good use. The program has supported 27 potential projects in Wisconsin involving 43 different commodities in the state. Mm. I think that right out the gate, you can say, okay, hey, we got something supporting our ag industry. We're giving our ag industry, our farmers, another
crop. We're investing in our future.
Mm. Another resource, another mm-hmm. thing to grow, another ability to make money.
Another way to keep
blunt.
The land healthy.
Yeah.
Also, that's because that's part of this.
And that part of it, there's layers and layers to this that just feel like they're so impactful mm-hmm. and such an important story. I encourage you to check it out. It's at Wisconsin Public Radio. You can look it there. There's plenty of other articles too. This is from March. This story. How many people heard about this out there?
Yeah. Unless you are a public radio reader or listener.
Certainly.
Good on you.
Certainly. Yes.
But there's also a number of people out there, James, who may not realize that farmland gets depleted from multiple crops growing in it. This is something that is climate smart and sustainable.
To the people out there, and specifically to the people out there voting for and the politicians out there that don't seem to think that this is an issue, our farmers,
yeah.
our ag industry, who need us, who mm-hmm. need us to have their back like they have ours. They are literally the backbone of this country.
They are why we have food.
Yeah. Yeah.
It really boils down to that. I don't know. Are they important, James?
Seems like
are
it.
Are they?
Seems. Let me look at my list here again of important. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, they are on there. They are actually in the top three, Melissa.
That's good. They should be.
They really should. And all that needs to be said and is important note. But it's also to take all that into context, think of all of those things while also realizing this is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like, this is pretty cool that we're figuring these things out, that we're able to do these things. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's vitally important with our climate being what it is and not being able to. One thing we certainly don't know, we can't guarantee any of this. We can't guarantee what's going to be going on in 20 years.
We can't guarantee we're going to get snow this year.
Yeah.
I mean, we will get it, but how much?
These rices are just the beginning of what they're learning to create and what they're being able to do. Mm-hmm. I think it's a fascinating story. I encourage people to look into that one quite a bit. And to piggyback off of that one, researchers have identified a heat-tolerant wheat that could improve yields in the warning world.
In a
world that's getting hotter and hotter, mm-hmm. and it's getting harder and harder for us to be able to grow things like this.
Right.
The trails in Mexico Sonora Desert found that the wheat offered up to 50 cent higher yields in hot weather compared to variants that are already formed.
Mm.
Quote, this is science we can now use to make an impact almost immediately. One of the researchers in England was quoted as saying, this is hopefully going to be the first of many steps to contribute to global food security in the coming years.
Yeah, which is vital. I mean, we got to have food.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
And we got to move with the times, or the weather, as it were.
Yes, well said, and well worded. And speaking of good words, oh man, I'm proud of that one. That felt good. Our friends at Quality Plus Printing joining us now with our wicked awesome word of Wednesday. Phil, how you doing?
Yeah, doing well. How about you guys this morning? Good segue, James.
Thank you, man. We're doing good over here.
Good. I'm glad you did that, Phil, because he was breaking his arm, patting himself on the back.
It's the one thing I take pride in is segues and transitions. Phil, we appreciate you joining us. As always, we love our friends over at Quality Plus Printing, not only joining us on Wednesdays here with our Wicked Awesome Word, but, of course, our main sponsor of Playmakers, our show you can catch Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 5 to 6. Looking to get Phil on there, talk a little tennis one of these days. Didn't want to say as a side note, Phil, congratulations to you and the team. Some really great performances this year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we had a good season. And in the end, our doubles team of Addie Ballett and Sarah Shaw went to state for the second year in a row and won their opening match and narrowly lost to a Final Four team to get in there. So, I guess to say it one way, they're in the top 16 teams in the state in Division II. So... and they almost got into the top, eight. So they did a very good job, and it was excellent. And then the whole team had a good year, but they getting the state 2 years in a row, first team ever to make it to the state from Assumption.
Wow.
And they've done it 2 years. So that's been really fun watching those two play, and the whole team. It's just been a group of great young ladies. So
that's awesome.
Thanks, Jane, for that.
Yeah, and thank you, and to that team for entertaining us and giving us some real fun front tennis action. I love tennis. I love being able to talk a little tennis. I don't feel like we get to talk about it nearly enough. I don't get to talk about WAM Incorporated is enough either, Phil. I want to remind everybody out there, we are calling all hometown heroes, looking for all you heroes out there.
Yeah, keep them coming in. Again, I got a few more, so yeah, I got to get now that tennis is done, I can concentrate a little bit and get some of those out. But thanks, James. If anybody knows somebody that just does some good deeds around the community, or someone that you want to see honored for doing the right thing, I mean, I see just as an example, there's a bunch of people with a truck down what used to be, in front of Pick and Save now, loading up goods to go down south to help people in the hurricanes. I mean, people like that are going above and beyond and donating their time to make good things happen like that. They deserve to be recognized, and those are the kind of people we want to put forth.
Absolutely.
So true. We appreciate everybody working really hard on that one and taking in those items. Phil, we have made the audience wait long enough. They have been so patient. What is our Wicked Awesome Word of Wednesday?
So I got one with a little flair today. So here we go. Glenday. N-D-E, D-U-E-N-D-E. It's Latin or Spanish in origin. And it just means to have a quality of having passion or inspiration.
Oh.
Personal magnetism, a little bit of, I think, a Zorro or Rico Suave.
Yes, yes. Charismatic people. Yes, yeah, I like that. Glenday. It also feels like that. Like it should have been the name of a pop song. Like I feel like at some point in our lives there should have been a song named Glenday. I don't know. That's a great word. It rhymes really good with other words too. So I think it's a good word, Phil. Nicely done.
My staff here said that they all have it except for me here.
That's why you hire good people, Phil. I learned that right away.
Yes.
I learned it right away. The only problem is
they tell you like it is.
Yeah, it's the mistake I made is not listening to Krusty the Clown and hiring people better than me. I'm more talented. I should have learned. Phil, I'm always curious of the projects you got going on over there. How are things going at the shop?
Oh, yeah. No, we're staying busy. We got a really cool one for, obviously, that you've been working on hard, too, James. We're printing the Miss Wisconsin Rapids programs today.
Ooh, nice.
Cool.
That'll be handed out. And, of course, I have a great affiliation with Maria, being Miss Wisconsin Rapids a year ago. And I've that program just does a great job with young ladies in that community. And the numbers are growing again. I think they have 15 teams and 7 up to the Miss, so those numbers are growing, and it should. They do such a good job teaching them a lot of life skills and award them with many scholarships. And we at Quality Plus Training are happy to help sponsor the scholarship competition and print these books. I mean, they're amazing. So this Saturday, right? Saturday night at 6 p.m.
Yep.
at the PCAC, so come support a lot of local young ladies who are going to give their all and learn a lot in the process.
Yeah, they've got, keep in mind, everybody, Friday they have you can check out the dress rehearsal if you'd like. I know a lot of people like being able to check that out, and especially if you're not able to make the show Saturday.
Yeah, the actual event. That's cool.
But the event will be Saturday. Be sure to find out more at MissWisconsinRapids.org, MissWisconsinRapids.org. And great work on those, Phil. Hear all the time from people in the community how much they appreciate the work you guys are doing and how good the strong quality of the work that you're doing over there.
Thanks, Tom. We talked about before, blessed to have a really great staff with Tracy and McKenna and Deb and Kathy and I don't know. Just have a good bunch of people here that are not only hardworking but have a lot of fun doing it. So that it makes for a really good time. Heather Sayers, too, comes and helps with the band, as you know, Heather. And so a whole bunch of really good people that I'm blessed to have in my life and that are here looking to make other people shine and have a good time doing it. So bring it on. We'll take more work.
Can I ask a question just between the three of us?
Mm-hmm.
Keep it between us, okay? Is there two Heathers? Is there two? Has she figured out how to doppelgang herself? She is everywhere. She is always doing stuff. Gosh, shout out to you, Heather. Shout out to you. Keep up the good work. And you guys keep up the great work too, Phil. We appreciate you.
Oh, thanks. Anytime I'm busy, I just look at Heather and go, I guess I'm not busy.
I mean, yeah. That's really
not
real.
That busy.
She does so much for so many people.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, thanks, James. And have a great day, you guys, and I appreciate you. And keep up the good work on the old local radio station, right?
Thanks, Phil.
You as well, Phil. We appreciate you. We'll talk again next Wednesday.
That sounds good. Take care. Now, have a great day.
Yeah.
You too. One of our favorite people to talk to, our friends over at Quality Plus Printing. Visit them today at 3515 8th Street South in Wisconsin Rapids. You can give them a call, 715-423-7440, 423-7440. Buy local, support local, support O's, and support us, support this community, everybody. And head on over to Quality Plus Printing Facebook page, like that page, keep up to date on all the cool things that they are doing over there, and be listening every Wednesday right in this time slot for another Wicked Awesome Word.
Wicked Awesome.
We'll be back with more fun in the morning show at WFHR.
There's a spook in Tin Pan Alley walking on the piano keys. He's a jiving ghost who can make the most of his rhythmic tendencies.
Welcome back, everybody. Morning show here at WFHR, locally grown radio. Melissa and James hanging out with you. Hope you're having a good one. Big shout out to the Bryan sisters for singing us in here.
So fun.
I love the harmonies of the style of music from back then.
Yes.
What they didn't have in production and you know, musical instruments or whatever, some of these things, they found ways to work around and still give you tons of sound and layers to that sound, which is really interesting. It's one thing to hear, you know, what Pink Floyd or you know, some of these bands that have been doing, you know, really working with technology like Radiohead or something and trying to find different layers of stuff. That stuff gets lost in the shuffle, but they were doing a lot of that back then, too.
Like they were doing it.
They had to be so creative.
Yeah, manually.
It's pretty cool.
They didn't have machines doing it for them.
How creative are you getting this Halloween, everybody? I don't know about anybody else, but doing the rounds when it comes to here in Wisconsin Rapids or when I go to Stevens Point, I'm there at least once a week, going in between our towns here and everything, just seeing a lot, it feels like a lot more Halloween decorations.
Mm.
I don't know the house, but there is a house in Stevens Point that has a literal giant pirate ship.
Yes.
It is so cool.
It is so cool. I took a picture of it when I drove by.
I did too.
Because it's a whole ship. Where do they put that? It's bigger than their garage.
I didn't even think of that. That is such a good question.
Not there all year.
No, I would want it to be there all year, but it's not. It just feels like there's been a lot more people getting into it this year, which has been a lot of fun and been cool to see, I think.
It is cool. I like seeing decorations. I don't do it myself personally. I've been thinking about it though.
Good.
Because I want to hand out candy, so I feel like my, you know, front door should look festive and welcoming.
Yeah, definitely.
Just got to figure out how to do that. That's your budget.
maybe we'll be able to help you with that. Maybe we'll get into that one before, because we got a bunch of Halloween topics to lead into next week. And I do want to remind everybody, next Thursday, almost a week from now, we're going to be kind of having some fun here for Halloween here on the morning show. Melissa and Seth and I will be enjoying that.
I get to wear my costume all day.
I'm looking forward to that. I can't wait. I want to wear mine now. I've been
well,
itching for this.
What's stopping you, James?
I really should, actually. Maybe just wear it straight. You know, it does seem a little unfair that you only get to wear it once. I've heard from a number of women when it comes to like their wedding dress and only getting to wear something like that once. And so many of them have like used it like, I'm going grocery shopping in this. Like I'm doing
something
else.
Or they turn it into they shorten the skirt and they turn it into a cocktail dress or something like that. Yeah. I mean, there are ways.
What are you dressing up as this year? Whatever you are doing, whatever you're dressing up as, if you're going out or anything like that, the majority of us, almost all of us, are going to be handing out candy or giving out candy of some kind.
Or taking candy.
Yes. That is, I'm more of the
not
latter.
Taking, receiving.
Yeah.
That's a better way to put it.
Trades. I do trades. A lot of IOUs. But what candy, you want to give out good candy, right? You want to give out the right candy. And by that, I mean just candy, because there is no wrong candy necessarily. I heard it as I said it. I heard it. Yeah. They're definitely.
Come on. As a kid, you knew what was the good candy and what wasn't. And going through, like, you go through your hall, not that I've ever experienced this, but I've seen it on the movies. Mm-hmm. You go through your hall when you get home from trick-or-treating and you section it out.
Yep.
Like, these are mine.
Yes.
These are the ones I may be willing to let my siblings poke through and trade with.
Yes.
And these are the ones I'd like to give away.
I had my pile. I had the pile for trades with my brother and sister. And then I had a secret pile that was for my dad so that he wouldn't poach my real candy. I wish I was kidding.
Dad's secret stash.
I would have like, hey, Dad, here's my, hey, what'd you get, Jimmy? Here's my haul. And it was just like candy I didn't really like that much. And I knew he liked. And it would keep him busy so that I could get into my Snickers, I'd get into my candies, and I liked it, everything. Halloween was a big deal at our house. And it was a fun thing for us to be able to be honest, as a poorer family, get to the point where we were able to hand out candy. Like, it meant a lot to my mom and dad to be able to do that. And I remember how important it was to my dad that we had full-size candy bars. He was going to do it that way. That was the way to do it and everything. That was the last year they did that. Yeah, it was the last year they did that. They went away from it afterwards. But I think that when we're talking about what the best candy to hand out is, that's one of the first answers you're going to see, whatever search engine you throw into or anything like that. Yeah. Oh,
chocolate.
And handing out the full-size bars if you're able to.
Yeah.
Now, keeping in mind that every one of us have a budget to worry about and everything, so keep that in context with this.
I think I have the best idea. Hmm. Can I get into it before you?
Okay. Yeah.
So, I want to give out a candy that will leave a lasting impression. Mm. You know, one that will last.
Yes.
So I'm thinking everlasting gobstoppers.
I was hoping you could, yes.
Or atomic fireballs.
Ooh, yeah. Yeah, those are good ones.
You know? I mean, come on. Like, that's not going to leave an impression.
I love this. I love this
idea. Somebody call up and tell me this is a bad idea.
Yeah, right. Yeah, please stop her.
Tell me what kind of candy to buy.
I love the idea of giving out a candy that they're going to recognize. Like, it's not just one, like, oh, another Snickers. Oh, another Milky Way. It's, something that, especially candies that we don't really see much of anymore, maybe, or something like that. Mm-hmm. I like that one. That's a good one. Well, according to a couple of lists that I saw, there's certainly going to be some different answers. But going to eater.com, I never heard of this website, eater.com, pretty straightforward. Shout out to them. The best candy to hand out to trick-or-treaters. They had a couple of answers here. One of them, full-size Halloween candy bar variety pack. So
of course,
you got your Milky Way, Three Musketeer, Twix, Snickers, all of those. SpongeBob SquarePants Giant Krabby Patty Gummy Candy. Say that one 10 times.
No, thank you.
Yeah. I don't know what that is, but it's one of the more popular candies, apparently.
Gummy candy.
Yeah, so it is. The Reese's King-Size Peanut Butter Cups are a big one.
But the thing is, you're going to fill up the kids' container, right off the bat.
I love the idea of just these a little dressed-up witch.
Dragging her pumpkin with all these full-size candy bars. And like, Mom, I can't.
You got to bring a pillowcase with you.
Apparently.
You got to bring a pillowcase with you.
You fit a lot more in there.
And sugar babies showed
up. Sugar babies. Ooh.
I forgot all about sugar
babies. I haven't
seen
those in a long time.
Yeah, I don't know if they're making a comeback or what it was, but I was really surprised to see
that one. Those are very similar to Milk Duds, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
From what I remember.
Sugar Babies is just a brand name.
Yeah. I mean, I think you can almost say that they're pretty much like
the same thing.
Yeah. They're caramel, where Milk Duds are more hard.
Okay.
From what, if I'm getting this right.
Well,
I apologize to any candyologists out there that... I think that's the proper term, candyologist.
Well, doesn't Sugar Babies also come as a sucker?
Ooh, I don't know, but I bet it does. I bet you they got a version of that.
So I think you got it backwards. I think Sugar Babies are a little harder, and Milk Duds are softer.
Mm-hmm. You can tell that is not my... Boy, if there's a candy I don't know, you might have hit that
but
one or like
now
Mounds.
That would be the one maybe I'll add to my everlasting gobstoppers and my atomic fireballs and the Sugar Baby suckers.
Otherwise, those are all a great list. Hot tamales are another one, Melissa. That shows up at number
You're
6.
You're talking about Red Hots this weekend.
Oh,
do you remember Red Hots?
Yeah, I remember those. Yeah, those were great. My sister loved those. Starburst were number 5. Skittles at number 4. Sour Patch Kids at number 3. Reese's Cups at 2. And M&M's at number 1.
Hey.
M&M's is...
Melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
I think that one of the things, especially for kids, I know for me, I always thought I was pulling a fast one when I could pick a candy bar and I got a Twix or, because you got 4, it felt like. You got multiples.
Right.
And with
more than one.
Skittles
bonus.
Or M&M's, similar thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that that's a win right there for
but
kids.
Number 1 in Minnesota, Reese's Pieces, which is how I got 10 cents off.
Nice. Right on. Anybody traveling to Minnesota, be sure to keep that knowledge
in hand. Caribou Coffee, get 10 cents off your coffee.
That's pretty... Oh. God, I love caribou coffee. It's so good. We will get into our schedule a little bit later. Looking forward to diving into that, everybody. I wanted to also remind everybody about Halloween. Halloween times. We want your Halloween events, Halloween times. Get them to us, everybody. You have heard during our commercial breaks Halloween
Here's
updates
what's happening.
We have. Yes. We want more of those happenings.
Mm-hmm. We want to share our community's goings-ons.
Great stuff going on in the community. That's our job. We want to highlight those.
There's a haunted house at El Cafe. On Sunday from 4 to 6 during their trunk or treat in the parking lot. So catch that because they're awesome.
Make plans to check that out, everybody. And stick around. We've got more show coming up for you right here.
This is locally grown radio. WFHR 1320 AM. W248 DE Wisconsin Rapids. And always streaming on the Civic Media app.